some new hair. You got some old fanniness. New wig. No, you need to start praising God just for the fact that He decided to be Lord over your life. He's Lord. He's Lord. He's Lord. And when He's Lord, you serve Him. James said, serve. Slave. Voluntary. Ministry of God and of the Lord. Jesus Christ. I'll leave you when I tell you this, Brother Riley. One year during the National Baptist Convention in New Orleans, Louisiana. A friend of mine, the Reverend Dr. Edward L. Branch, we made our way to New Orleans, contending that we had somewhere to stay during the week, lodging. That church say, hotel. Only to discover that there were some issues with the parties that we put in charge to make our reservation, which did not complete the process. So when we get to the Hilton in New Orleans, we have no room. And standing in a long line, we discovered other people were having some issues. Some were pushing, shoving, others screaming, and giving the personnel the number one sign with a different fan. Church food. We spotted a young preacher whose character has always been questionable, at least among the preaching ranks. Reverend Gary Hummer walked up to us and said, "Preachers, anything wrong?" And we said, "Yeah, man, we got a problem. We don't have any rooms here." He said, "Y'all ain't got no room?" We said, "No, man, we don't have any room." He said, "What happened?" "We don't know." He said, "Y'all ain't got no room?" He said, "Hold on a minute." And I don't know what Gary Hunter has within him. I call it nerve. Walked behind the desk, asked for the manager, turned his back towards us, told the personnel, "I need to talk to the manager." She quickly went to the back room, brought the manager out. They shook hands. We couldn't hear a word they were saying. Finally, the manager escorted him into the office, stayed there about 5 minutes, came out, and the manager was beckoning for me and Pastor Branch, gesturing for us to come to his office door. When we got there, he handed us keys to sleeps. You didn't get it. Us on the shoulder and said, "We're sorry, pastors, that you're having this kind of trouble." Yeah. When the manager went back into his office, we walked away with our luggage. Gave the honor, patted us on the other shoulder and said, "Listen, man, y'all owe me one." I don't know how he did what he did, but whatever he did, he went between us and the management and made sure that arrangements were made for our accommodation. Come here for a minute. I'm out of here now. When the Lord does for you what He does for you, don't think that He has to do it. But whenever He does it, I can see Him tapping you on your shoulder every morning and say, "Since I woke you up, you owe me one. Since I dried your tears, you owe me one. Since I healed your sick body, you owe me one." Talk to me, somebody. Isn't anybody here who knows that you owe Him one? Because one day sin got between you and God, but along came Jesus and worked it out between you and God. And you mean to tell me you can come up in here These are people who know they owe it. If you ain't dead, every day you're in debt, you owe it. One writer said, what shall I render? Psalm 160. What shall I render unto the Lord? For all of his benefits towards me. I'll pay my vows. I'll take the cup of salvation. And I'll call upon his name in the presence of all his people. What shall I render? Beloved, when you know what the Lord has done for you, it ought to compel you to want to serve him. When I was much more of a boy than I am now, I used to follow my mama to what they then called Willing Workers Meeting. And it was a group of about 10 to 15 women. And they would generally serve refreshments, cookies and punch, and little chicken drumlets. And of course, being a young boy, I wasn't going for the Willing Workers Meeting. I followed mama because I knew that they were going to have something to eat. But I see now that by my having hung around, there were some residual effects of the lessons they used to teach and the song that they always opened up with. And whenever the prayer was given and the song was rendered or the scripture read, they would always sing, I'm glad to be in the service. One more time. I didn't understand it then, but I declare I know what they're talking about now. Life is so volatile. Life is so variable. Life is so frail. Life is so fragile until you don't know what the next day is going to bring. So whenever you get a chance to serve and celebrate God, your theme song ought to be, I'm glad to be in the service. One more time. He didn't have to let me live, so I'm glad to be in the service one more time. Who told you that you would be here tomorrow? Who told you that you would see next Sunday morning? So since you don't know, the same change told you that your life is just like a vapor. You are here in one instance, and then you're gone. So that you have a chance now to render service and celebration unto God. This is a mighty good time to come on out of the closet. James said, I am a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. I need to hear somebody shout, scatter. James said, I've got to come out of the closet because the Lord helped me to survive. The Lord gave me the privilege to serve. Oh, praise his name. But I've got to come out of the closet because he gave me something to share. But even though he gave me something to share, it happened under peculiar circumstances. When he said to the saints, scatter, it was because of the early church, but because the persecution spread in the church from Jerusalem to Judea, the other parts of the globe, what looked like it was bad turned out to be good. Because if it wasn't for the trouble, the church never would have left Jerusalem. If it wasn't for the trouble, it never would have gotten scattered. Oh, praise his name. Now my oldest brother is in the church tonight. He has a big garden in his yard. He's got corn, he's got tomatoes, he's got beans, and he's got greens. But when you walk in the garden, the tomatoes are in one section, the beans are in another section, the greens are in another section. Oh, praise his name. And what we see now is a result of him throwing seed and scattering seed in the ground. And when he put the seed in the ground, the rain fell. The seed germinated. The seed sprouted and became greens and beans and tomatoes. Shake somebody's hand and tell them, don't mind the trouble. God uses trouble as a seed, and he scattered over his land. If it weren't for the scattering, you wouldn't be here tonight. If it weren't for the scattering, the word of God never would have left Jerusalem. If it would have never left Jerusalem, it never would have gotten to Rome. If it never would have gotten to Rome, it never would have made it to Europe. If it had not gotten to Jerusalem, it never would have made it to Africa. If it had not made it to Africa, it never would have made it across the Atlantic. If it never would have made it across the Atlantic, we never would be in this house tonight. Shake somebody's hand and tell them, thank God for the scattering. The Lord was taking trouble to plant a seed. The Lord was taking heartache to plant a seed. The Lord was taking peril and fright to plant his seed. And you are here tonight sharing the celebration. James said to all of the saints scattered, greeting. Shake somebody's hand and tell them that simply means I'm still here. Is there anybody in the house ready?